So some of the most popular content that people put out is when a Windows user tries out Linux for the first time. Those are very popular videos. They're very popular news articles. People eat up that kind of content because Windows users love it because they assume Linux is a horrible operating system, and this Windows user that's trying out Linux for the first time, he's going to have a bad time and it's going to be entertaining, right? And Linux users also eat up this kind of content because they want to see this Windows user use Linux and fall in love with it and become a Linux advocate, become a convert, right? And while it's entertaining content, my problem with this kind of content, these videos, these articles, when Windows users try out Linux for the very first time, is they almost never come at it the right way. For one thing, most of them come at it with the mindset, I'm going to switch from Windows to Linux and make Linux be Windows. And if you come at it in that direction, it's never going to work. It's never going to work out right. You're going to have a horrible time. You're going to fail, and you're going to fail. I'm talking about crash, flames. It's just going to be a gigantic disaster because I don't think enough people, and I understand why they don't. They assume all operating systems are the same because they know Windows is out there. They know Mac OS is out there. They know Chrome OS is out there, and they're all the same. They're all proprietary software, and they kind of all do things the same way, where Linux is something fundamentally different. That, unless you are upfront with this difference, you will never be able to switch from Windows or any proprietary operating system to Linux until you come to terms with the fact that Linux is free and open source software. Windows is proprietary software. And because that, at the core of the operating system, is the key difference. If you don't wrap your head around that, you're not going to be in for a good time when you make the switch. You have to understand, Windows as proprietary software does things completely differently than Linux can do as free and open source software. Those ideals, free and open source software versus proprietary, two completely opposed ideas. And because of that, Linux will never be Windows. It will never be anything like Windows. And also, Windows will never be anything like Linux. Again, because proprietary software versus free and open source software, those ideas are just so radically different. And these Windows users that are trying out Linux, you know, they're thinking they're going to come at it and they're going to force Linux to be just like Windows. All their hardware is going to work. They're going to make it work, right? All the software availability, it's going to be there too. All the programs they run on Windows, they'll get it to work on Linux somehow, even if there's no native Linux version. You know, well, I'll use Wine, which is kind of a Windows emulator, not really, but sort of, and or they'll use a Windows virtual machine just for their Windows programs, or they'll do all of this, you know, jumping through hoops to make Linux be Windows. And it never works out right, because even things like Wine and virtual machines to run your Windows programs, that's not a great experience. That's not as good of an experience as just running your Windows programs on Windows. And again, it's because they came at this not knowing the difference between proprietary software and free and open source software, right? Here's the real deal with Linux being a free and open source piece of software. Is that, you know, the people that use Linux, they don't use Linux because it's a better operating system than Windows. And when I say better, what most people think is better, hardware support, software availability, and drivers and things like that, performance, you know, we don't care about that stuff. I mean, we care about it, but that's not the reason we use free and open source software. The reason we use free and open source software over proprietary software is because of it being free and open source software. That's it. That's the core of the matter. The heart of the matter is the fact that Linux is free and open source software is the reason many of us use Linux. That's the only reason. It's because we want that freedom. You know, we're trying to get away from the evils of proprietary software, which typically has a lot of spyware and malware and tracking, all of this stuff built into it. It doesn't respect you as the user, yada, yada, yada. I preach the message of free and open source software on my channel all the time. I'm not gonna, you know, spend all that time on this video doing it, but you have to understand that there's a Linux community, right? There's a free and open source software community that is different than Windows, which doesn't have a community. I mentioned this on video the other day, and some people took offense to when I said that Windows doesn't have a community, that there's a Linux community, but Windows, there's no Windows community. People were like, man, there's billions of Windows users around the world. Of course there's a Windows community. There's billions of Windows users, but that's not a community. A community is people that are actually involved with something, right? They identify with something. And, you know, Linux has a community because it's free and open source software. You know, there's all these people around the world that help build Linux. And just free and open source software in general, there's countless millions of people around the world that help develop free and open source software. Because of that, we're a community, right? We're involved. We're all part of this thing. Where you, as a Windows user, you're not really part of Windows development, right? It's proprietary software. You can't even see the code. You can't be a part of developing Windows, right? It's a proprietary software. The only people that can actually work on Windows are the employees at Microsoft, and really probably just a few special employees at Microsoft can actually, you know, dive deep into the code of Windows, because again, the proprietary nature of it, you know, they don't want a whole lot of people, you know, eyeballing that code because of some of the nasty things that are probably in there. So, you know, some of the complaints that these Windows users have about Linux is the fact that there's so many different Linux distributions. It's free and open source software. Anybody can do whatever they want with a piece of free and open source software. They can fork it, they can name it something else, they can make it their own. That's why we have a million different Linux distributions, and pretty much any piece of free and open source software is like this. It's not just Linux, but I can take any free and open source software. Maybe there's a free and open source text editor that I like, but I don't like some of what they're doing, and I go to that project and, hey, I want to make these changes. I think, you know, your text editor currently does things this way. I want it to do this way. And I open an issue on their GitHub or their GitLab, and they say, nope, we're not doing that because we don't agree with that direction. We're going in the direction we've been going in. And I'm like, well, you know what? It's free and open source software. I'll fork your project and I'll make the changes I want to make. I'll rename it. And now, you know, you have basically this text editor of mine that's very similar to the one that I forked it from, but, you know, some minor tweaks. That's the beauty of free and open source software, is you have that freedom. Of course, Windows users, or proprietary software users in general, don't understand this when you've got a million different similar things going on. It's like, why are all these people working on different things? Why aren't they all working on the one thing? Well, we're not all working on the one thing is because nobody can agree on one thing, right? And the only people that can agree on one thing is the proprietor of proprietary software. You know, that's why there's only one Windows, is because there's only one Microsoft, right? And nobody else can work on Windows but Microsoft. That's why you get just the one, right? Free and open source software, again, fundamentally different. Anybody can do whatever the hell they want with free and open source software. They can change it, they can modify it, they can redistribute those modified versions of the program, they can fork it, you know, call it a different name, and just keep developing their own version of that particular software. And again, I just, not enough of these Windows users that are trying out Linux come into it with this kind of knowledge up front. They come into it thinking that, well, Linux is just like Windows. It's just like Mac. It's just like Chrome OS. It's just another piece of software, and it's going to act exactly like all of this proprietary garbage software that I've been using, where Linux, because of the freedom involved, again, it operates completely, fundamentally differently. And then you've got these Windows users that complain about Linux. They have to use the command line. They have to use the terminal for certain things. Well, you don't necessarily have to, but if you are kind of a power user, you're a tinkerer, you know, you're one of those people that like to configure things, configure your system. And there's a lot of Windows users that are like this too. You know, you like tweaking things, right? Well, if you like that, then you're gonna love Linux and the command line and the terminal, because literally anything you want to do on Linux, you can do through the command line. It's a little bit different on a proprietary operating system like Windows, for example. There's some customization you can do, but just a very little bit, right? They don't allow you to do much because the system is locked down in such a way you can't really make fundamental changes to things, where in Linux you can rip out the guts, right? You can completely hose your system if you want to. Linux gives you that freedom. And You know, a lot of people are like, well, why do I have to use the terminal for so many of these power user kind of things? Why can't there just be a GUI for everything, a graphical program that allows me to do all of this stuff? It's because I think too many people don't realize how powerful the command line is. There's, you know, thousands and thousands of programs that are command line programs, and many of these programs are really complicated. They're large programs. For example, in Linux, we have the find command, which is a command line program that searches for files and directories on your system based on whatever parameters you give it. And there is a whole bunch of parameters to it, right? You can search based on a file name and extension and when the last time it was modified, when the last time that file was accessed, and yada, yada, yada. If you read the man page for find, it is gigantic. It's massive. It'd take you all day to read the man page for find. And then, you know, well, why is it so complicated to search for a file on Linux at the command line? Why can't they just make a GUI tool that's good? Well, your graphical tool would have to essentially be a front end to the find command, which has a bajillion things you could do with it. You'd have to make a graphical program that could do a bajillion things as well, right? It would be a complicated thing to do. You could do it if you wanted to. You have that freedom in Linux. You could absolutely make a piece of software, you know, free and open source software that could do this. It would just be a ton of work to basically recreate something that's already able to be done at the command line. I know, you know, like your grandma's not going to go to the command line and search for files and directories at the command line. There are simple search and replace tools and things like that for Linux that have graphical front ends. They're usually not very good, but you can use them. For the power user, though, you do eventually have to get under the hood a little bit and learn some of the basic shell commands. And of course, by me talking through all of this, you know, many Windows users are going to say, well, Linux is just complicated. And that's what these videos of these Windows users trying out Linux, they make it, Linux look complicated. These articles that people write, they make Linux look complicated. And me on this video rambling, I mean, some of the stuff I just told you about the command line and all, I'm making Linux sound complicated, and it is, right? Why is Linux so much more complicated than Windows? Well, again, the differences between proprietary software and free and open source software. The fundamental difference is free and open source software lets you do whatever the hell you want to do. And whatever the hell you want to do is an infinite amount of things, right? That's why it's complicated. Proprietary software, there's this small set of things that you're allowed to do, that you're permitted to do, and that's all you will ever be able to do with proprietary software. And that's why, yeah, Windows is easy, right? Windows is simple to use and easy to set up, and, you know, anybody can use it. And Linux is complicated and it's hard, and it's for nerds, it's for geeks. Yeah, I mean, that's the truth. But and we're okay with that, the Linux community. I don't know why people outside the Linux community seem to have a problem with that. Like, they're throwing out all of this, these nasty things about the Linux, the operating system, and Linux, the community. You know, all you guys are arrogant, elitist, a-holes, yada, yada, yada. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of, again, the fundamental difference between proprietary software and free and open source software. And that's okay. That's okay. We can be different. You know, the proprietary software and free and open source software, I mean, they coexist, right? They can coexist. They will always coexist. We're always going to have proprietary software, and we're always going to have free and open source software, and we're always going to have people that use proprietary software and free and open source software. I mean, we're always going to have those advocates, those zealots that strictly want to use free and open source software due to the freedom aspect, and that's okay. You know, it's one of those things we can all get along, right? And it's okay if you're a Windows user and you've tried Linux and it didn't work out, or you don't care about the philosophy. All you care about is whether that piece of software that you need to use on a daily basis works, or that game works, and you get the best frame rate on that game on Windows rather than on Linux, or your RGB mouse, you know, the lighting doesn't work on Linux, but it works on Windows, and it was an expensive mouse, so I'm going to use Windows so I can use my mouse. That's great. Do that if that's what you want to do. Nobody's saying you have to use Linux. The other thing is, even though people like me are out there promoting free and open source software in general and the Linux operating system, you know, we're spreading that message for people that are interested in that message. If you're not interested in free and open source software at all, then to be honest, I don't know why you would be interested in Linux at all. So if you don't care about free and open source software, hey, be happy on Windows or be happy on Mac or whatever proprietary operating system you're currently running. Hey, that's fine. I don't care, right? It's one of those things that the message of free and open source software, if you want to listen, great. And if you do listen, it provides real benefits. In some ways, it's a life-changing kind of thing, because it definitely, it's a lifestyle change, free and open source software in a lot of ways. And again, it's not for everybody. I choose it because I've seen real world benefits of using free and open source software versus proprietary software. But if you're strictly not interested, hey, be happy on Windows, and that's okay. And also, if you're happy on Windows, don't attack Linux users who love talking about Linux and free and open source software. Let them be happy running their operating system as well. All right, guys. Peace.